All right, so now that we know how to graph by plotting a whole bunch of points, we want to investigate some characteristics of lines. We're going to investigate what information we need from graph of a line to get its equation, what kind of equations represent lines, and what characteristics of a line are found in an equation of a line. All right, so let's start with the following question. Put a point on a piece of paper and tell me how many lines can you draw that go through this one point. So go ahead, pause the video and investigate on your own. Assuming you have done that, so let's say I have a point 4, 3, and I want to know how many lines go through it. So I just put a point arbitrarily here, and I know here's one line that goes through the point 4, 3. Well, I'm going to take this point Q and see what I can do with it. So if I turn it, look at all the different lines that I am getting when I turn. These are all the lines that are going through the point 4, 3. And so if I look, I have all these lines that go through point P. So infinitely many lines go through a fixed point P, 4, 3. You can put the point anywhere you want, but if you have one fixed point, infinitely many lines can go through it. Okay, so now second question would be, well, what if you had 2 points? How many lines go through 2 points? So go ahead and see what you can do. Pause the video here, see how many lines go through 2 points. So if I have point P and Q fixed, clearly this is one of the lines that go through it. So let's see, can any other line go through it? Nope. Every other line has a different point on it. So if it has to go through the Q, there's only one such line. So 2 points determine a line uniquely. So remember, infinitely many lines go through a fixed point, but only a unique line goes through 2 fixed points. All right, well, suppose I ask you, take a look at the following. I put a point here, point here, point here, and I look at those coordinates. What kind of coordinates? They all have x coordinate 4. So this one has x coordinate 4, y coordinate negative 5, negative 4, negative 3, negative 2, and so on. Take a look. This line that goes through it is a vertical line. And what's the characteristic of this vertical line? It's x equals 4. The x coordinate is fixed. In general, then, suppose I have this line here, x equals 4. You can see what we just saw is that the y coordinate, right? The y coordinate is what changes, the x remains fixed. If I move the x coordinate, now look, I get a different line. So now I have x coordinate is 3, and I can move my y coordinate up and down in another vertical line. So vertical lines have the characteristic that the x coordinate is fixed. You can see I can pick pretty much any x-coordinate I want, as long as the x-coordinate remains fixed and y-coordinate can be anything, you have a vertical line. Similarly, what do you think will be horizontal line? So if you look to horizontal lines, then look, here's my horizontal line that goes through the point 3, negative 2. And if I move the y-coordinate, then the y-coordinate switches. So here I have a horizontal line that goes through y equals negative 2 and x coordinate is 2. But I can move the x coordinate left or right, but the y coordinate remains fixed. If I move the line, then the y coordinate changed. And now again, if I move the x coordinate, I still get the horizontal line. So vertical line, x coordinate is fixed, right? And what about horizontal line then? Horizontal lines, you have y coordinate is fixed and it's the x coordinate that changes. So y equals negative 2, y equals negative 5.5, y equals 0 is our x-axis, y equals 3. So a general characteristic of a horizontal line is that the y coordinate is fixed. So vertical lines are x equals a, where a is the fixed coordinate and y coordinate can be anything. Horizontal lines, the y coordinate is fixed and x coordinate can be any real number. So if I ask you, sketch the graph of and find the equation of a vertical line passing through the point negative 3, 4. So here's my coordinate axis, here's my x equals negative 3, which is a vertical line, and the equation would be x equals negative 3. If I ask you to find vertical line passing through half negative 9, then x equals 1 half is my vertical line, and so here's my equation, x equals 1 half. All right, try this next one on your own. And see if you got the right answer. So now, since you're doing horizontal line, it'll be y equals negative 4, y equals 5. That's how you get horizontal lines. All right, try this for your homework.